Some will come on Saturday night, some will come on Sunday. If you give them half a chance, they'll be back on Monday. Swinter. Live and learn.
So my name is Nich Wilbur. We are in the control room of the Anacortes Unknown Recording Studio. We are recording music today. So what we just did, we recorded a guitar and two vocals and a mandolin. We're going to talk about that process and how that happened. This is a recording studio. It's in the old Catholic church in Anacortes. It's been converted. The control room is where me, the recording engineer, hangs out. And this is all the equipment that controls the levels and actually does the recording. Got a computer over here. And then we also have a tape machine, which is kind of the old way of recording. And a lot of my process uses both the tape machine and the computer to get the sound of the tape machine, but still have the flexibility of manipulating it in a computer. As a recording engineer, I like recordings that have character, like recordings that where you can hear the recording gear that you're using. Like a lot of old recordings, they have a cool sound. Some recording engineers nowadays believe that the recording equipment should be as transparent as possible. That isn't as interesting to me. It's more exciting to use stuff that I feel like is doing something. So I moved to Anacortes 12 years ago. I'm from Arkansas originally. I moved here because of a place called the Department of Safety. It looked amazing on the internet. It was still cool in real life, but I was under the impression I had a recording studio. I did not have a recording studio. I got here and there was like pretty much nothing as far as a recording studio. And so that kind of is what inspired me to start a recording studio. I was like, let's start a recording studio here. But then that place closed down. I moved all that stuff into the Keystone building. And then this space became available. Then, yeah, started a better recording studio here. I was able to like make a career out of being a recording engineer because of this space. I feel like I wouldn't have been able to do that in the Keystone building because of the restrictions there. But no, this space has its own sound. People want to come here because it's a big room with lots of natural reverb. Okay, so we're going to start with a musician downstairs sitting in a chair, playing guitar and singing. We're gonna have two microphones. One microphone's gonna be on the guitar, and one microphone's gonna be on the vocal. And those are gonna come through the cables up here to what's behind me. It's called the patch bay. All these cables down here. The patch bay is what connects everything in the recording studio together. And so it's gonna come from downstairs to the patch bay, and then the patch bay is gonna connect the microphone to this first, which is a mixing console. And this is gonna control the level of the microphone as it gets recorded onto the tape machine here. And then after that, we're gonna record it from the tape machine into the computer. We could just record it straight to the computer, but I personally like the sound of the tape machine, so I go to the tape machine and then record it on the computer. Just one extra step, but I think it's worth it. So we finished recording the guitar and the vocals. Now we want to do a mandolin overdub. An overdub means recording on top of something that's already been recorded. So we're going to move to a new track on the tape machine, and we're going to record the mandolin. And Jeff's going to hear the guitar and the vocals in his headphones and play along to it. Part of this job is I love living in Anacortes. I'm gonna name a few things maybe. I love living in Anacortes, but socially it's really quiet, and I feel like having all these people come from different towns and hanging out with them and working on creative projects with them and getting to know them in this cool way is awesome, exciting. Like, I feel really grateful for that. I also like having a job where I can use my brain and be creative, even though it's, like, exhausting sometimes, but yeah, it's always different, too. Always doing something different, always problem-solving. I like problem-solving a lot. So after everything's recorded, we have all the tracks that we want, then comes the mixing part. So we have all the tracks, and we go through them. We do fine adjustments of EQ, which is, like, messing with the tone of an instrument or vocal. And then adding effects like reverb, echo, flanger. Usually not flanger, but yeah. And then we mix it down to a stereo track. Like, say we have, like, a rock song, so we have, like, 10 tracks for the drums, 4 tracks of guitars, 1 bass, 3 vocals. We take all those tracks, we run through the mixing board here of all the different levels and give a level set, and this will mix it down to 2 channels, so it's stereo. And it's like a more finalized version. And then that goes to the mastering step, which just does a little bit, just like adjusts the tone of the track, makes it louder, just makes it more finished sounding. I record all different kinds of music. I guess most of it would be more like rock style music, where it's like drums, guitar, bass, vocals. But some of it's just acoustic guitar. Some of it's more experimental, ambient music. I usually ask them how they're going to release it, like if they're going to put it on just CD, if they're going to put it up on just the internet, if they're going to do cassettes or vinyl, and then I'll give them different versions of the files based on that. Either I can put it on a CD or I can send it through email. It's usually a WAV file. Another common one would be AIFF, which is just an Apple version of a WAV file. But yeah, and sometimes they ask for MP3s too, but they don't sound as good as the WAV file. I do feel like fulfilled in that way by doing this job a lot of the time. Because you get to, I feel like it's mostly problem solving. It's just like, which for some people can be really overwhelming, but once you get past all those problems, for me it's really rewarding and exciting. I have like a finished product.
Someone spoke, cried tears, hope. We might change this time. When I looked into their eyes, the fear I saw was mine. Swing and turn. Live and learn. Swing and turn. Live and learn, choose.